Welcome to this Bend the Curve webcast. Bend the Curve is an educational campaign developed by NEHI with support from the WellPoint Foundation, aimed at providing healthcare leaders with actionable ways to reduce spending without impacting quality in an effort to create high-value healthcare. The campaign covers seven critical areas of wasteful healthcare spending and seeks to provide health professionals with data to identify where costs can be reduced and recommendations for actionable solutions. In this webcast, we'll be looking at the problem of emergency department overuse. Targeting the $38 billion spent annually on ED overuse requires building on proven practices and implementing policy actions that target the root causes of the problem. These include offering alternative approaches to primary care, specialized services for vulnerable populations, and effective chronic disease management, among others. But before we talk about the tools healthcare leaders can utilize to reduce ED overuse, we first have to talk about the size and scope of this very real healthcare issue. Each year, millions of Americans arrive at an emergency department to seek care for a non-urgent condition. The consequences of this overuse are well established: overcrowded emergency rooms, uncoordinated care, and billions of dollars in unnecessary healthcare spending. It's been estimated that nationally 56%, or roughly 67 million ED visits, are potentially avoidable. In addition, the average cost of an ED visit is said to be about $580 more than the cost of a comparable office visit. Patients arrive at the ED with anything and everything. Asthma flare-ups, diabetic complications, the common cold, the flu, even cases of the sniffles. All types of patients use the ED for non-urgent care, including all age groups, insurance types, even insured patients with the usual source of primary care. And one-third of ED visits are made during regular business hours when primary care offices should be open. For thousands each day, the ED is their first source of health care, not their refuge in an emergency. In turn, patients know that they can receive care anytime, regardless of the severity of their condition. Furthermore, the ED provides patients with immediate feedback and reassurance, and a wide range of healthcare services are readily available in the department. There are a variety of reasons why primary care finds itself in a crisis, but some of the more significant causes include a lack of timely appointments and available after-hours care, chronically ill patients who often have no access to primary care who have poorly coordinated care, and primary care practices that instruct patients to seek care in the ED outside of normal business hours. Reducing ED overuse requires building on a set of coordinated, proven practices in the field, coupled with policy actions in both the public and private sectors. The following slides talk a bit more about how these proven practices and policy actions can help to address this issue. Primary care must be elevated to priority status in the healthcare system and given the financial and technical resources necessary to provide appropriate care to more patients, as improving access to primary care can reduce ED overuse by up to 56%. Moreover, patients receiving care from a primary care practice offering weekend hours have been found to use the ED 20% less than patients who don't have access to care at weekends. Primary care practices themselves must work in new ways, such as extending access to care by making care convenient for patients with busy work and family lives. One way to do this is through the use of 24-hour telephone consultation services. For example, a physician-staffed service was found to reduce avoidable ED use by 41% to only 8% of visits, and a nurse-staffed service was found to reduce ED utilization by 4.3% and produce an annual net savings of nearly $400,000. In addition to improving access to more traditional primary care services, new sources of care must be made available, including retail clinics and virtual visits enabled by telehealth. Freestanding hospital-based urgent care clinics, for example, can reduce ED use by nearly 48%, and those patients who had telehealth virtual visits with clinicians have been found to use the ED 22% less than those who didn't. A number of tested measures already exist for reducing ED overuse, including specialized services for vulnerable populations, as housing and case management support have been found to reduce ED use in those populations by nearly a quarter. Another proven practice for reducing ED overuse is effective chronic disease management. For example, chronically ill adults who participated in a program of group visits with other patients with similar diseases have been found to use the ED 17% less than patients who don't participate in these group visits. A number of tested policy actions have track records in reducing ED overuse, including reforming payment for providers. Adopting payment approaches that enable providers to invest in primary care improvements, such as extended hours and information technology, and implementing performance-based payment systems that use patient ED utilization or appointment wait times as quality metrics are two ways to address this. Providers are not the only ones who must be incentivized to cut down on ED overuse. Patients have a role in this as well. This could be done by reducing copays for patients who use urgent care clinics and by increasing copayments for patients who use the emergency department in non-urgent situations. One last way to reduce ED overuse that we've identified in our work relates to the sharing of ED utilization data. There's a number of ways to go about this, but two concrete examples are to provide hospital utilization data on avoidable ED visits to a patient's PCP, or to provide health plan claims data to healthcare professionals on the ED utilization of their patient populations. That brings us to the end of this Bend the Curve webcast. We hope that the webcast has been enjoyable and informative. If you'd like a copy of this presentation in PowerPoint form, or you'd like to learn more about this or any of the other Bend the Curve topics, please visit the website at www.nehi.net/bendthecurve. On the website, you'll find the Healthcare Leader's Guide to High-Value Healthcare, policy briefs, PowerPoint presentations, and more of these webcasts. We encourage you to use these tools to educate your colleagues, as well as to identify and implement successful solutions aimed at addressing the very real problem of healthcare waste in your organizations and communities. Thank you, and take care.